everyone, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing well. I can't believe January is already over. January always feels like such a long month because the beginning of the month feels so different from the end of the month, and a lot has happened this month. I'm so glad that the United States has a new president. But yeah, today I just wanted to sit down and chat about some of the things that I've been really liking this month. I really want to try to do a monthly favorites for every month for the year. I feel like they're really fun to look back on, and I think it'll help me a lot when I film my yearly favorites video, because for those yearly roundups, I feel like there's definitely a lot of like recency bias for that. But I do want to keep track of things that I really liked towards the beginning of the year as well. And even if these things aren't like holy grail status or yearly favorite status, I think it's still really fun to talk about a couple of noteworthy things that have stuck out in a pretty short time frame. And for this month's favorites, we have quite the variety. We have a couple of beauty products, I have some fashion favorites, we have some lifestyle laundry favorites, and a productivity favorite. So let's go ahead and start with beauty. The first beauty product that I fell in love with during this month is the Rowan Beauty Kiss My Liquid Lip Balm, and I have it in the shade Charlie. I don't think this brand gets enough love on YouTube, but they have some really beautiful products. I have their eyeshadow palettes as well. But I picked up this liquid lip balm during one of the holiday sales, and I had heard that some people really like this product, but I really wasn't expecting too much. But as soon as I put it on my lips, I fell in love. I'm wearing it on my lips today, and it gives my lips a nice balmy shine to it that isn't too over the top and glossy. Definitely adds a little something. The color Charlie is like the perfect my lips but better rosy color. And what I love about this product is that it really is just like a tinted lip balm. It's something that looks good whether you're wearing a lot of makeup or not, but it's just like a level above of what you would think when you think of a tinted lip balm. The packaging is gorgeous, and just like the experience of using a doe foot applicator to apply the product definitely is a more elevated experience. But it's so comfortable on the lips. It feels really nice and smooth and has a little bit of a slip to it. The color is still nice and sheer, so you can still see your lips underneath and it still looks really natural, but it just brightens up your face and makes you look and feel a little bit more put together. The product also has a little bit of a peppermint scent to it, which I wasn't really expecting to like so much, but it really just makes the product feel so nice on the lips and kind of like wakes me up a little bit whenever I apply it. As someone who really doesn't wear any kind of lip product besides lip balm on an everyday basis and doesn't really like to have anything on my lips, it says a lot if there's a lip product that I'm actually reaching for on an everyday basis. So I really love this product so much, and I really want to get another shade. It comes in three colors, and I think the more beigey nude color would be so pretty. Next up, I have a new mascara that I've been enjoying during the month. This is the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara in Waterproof, and I randomly saw this in Target one day and grabbed it because I know back on like the very early days of YouTube, there was a lot of hype around this mascara, and I don't know if they discontinued it and brought it back or something, but I remember trying to look for it and not being able to find it. So I picked up this mascara, and I'm actually really surprised at how much I like it. Again, I am wearing this mascara today, and it's definitely more of a lengthening mascara, I would say. It has a very small plastic wand, and normally the plastic bristled wands aren't my favorite, but I've been using more and more mascaras that have them, and I've been enjoying them. They're definitely a lot better at separating and defining the lashes, but I do find that this mascara actually builds up volume pretty easily. I kind of wiggled the wand through my lashes today, and I feel like I was able to build it up really quickly. It's always fun trying a new mascara, and it's nice to have an alternative to the Japanese mascaras that I typically use. The thin wand also makes it really easy to apply it to your bottom lashes, which is also really nice, so I have been enjoying this guy a lot. And then next up in beauty, I think I might have discovered my new favorite eyebrow pencil. I recently posted a video trying out a bunch of products from Jason Wu Beauty that I will link in the corner. A lot of the products are really good, but definitely the standout for me was this eyebrow pencil. This is just your typical micro brow pencil that has a spoolie on one end and a really thin little eyebrow pencil on the other. There are a ton of brands that make eyebrow pencils like this, but the thing I love the most about this one is the color of it. I have mine in the shade medium, and it's just like the perfect ashy brown color for my eyebrows. I think a lot of brown eyebrow pencils tend to be a little bit too warm, and this one is just really nice and ashy and blends really well into my eyebrows. It is what I have in my brows today, and combined with my favorite eyebrow gel, which is the M Cosmetics brow cream, I have been really enjoying how my brows have been looking. And then lastly for beauty, the eyeshadow palette that I've been loving lately is this Charlotte Tilbury eyeshadow palette. This is the Bejeweled Eyes to Hypnotize eyeshadow palette, and I always have to look up the name of this palette because she has a couple of different variations that I think she comes out with every holiday season. And I believe this one is from this current slash past season. I know I just spent quite a bit of money on a couple of Charlotte Tilbury eyeshadow quads that I absolutely love. But when I saw this palette go on sale for like 40 bucks, which is less than a single Charlotte Tilbury eyeshadow quad, I decided to pick it up. And at first I wasn't sure how I felt about this palette because it doesn't have any of the pop shades, which are in all of the Charlotte Tilbury quads. The pop shades are like a glittery topper, and those are always some of my favorite eyeshadows. But even without the pop shades, I do really enjoy using this palette. I just really like Charlotte Tilbury eyeshadows. She just makes it so easy to get an eyeshadow look that looks like it took a lot more effort than it did. This palette is really nice because it does have quite a few neutral brown golden tones, which are my favorite for an everyday basis. But I also have been playing around with the pink and purple shades in the middle, and I find that they're also very wearable and easy to use. I'm actually wearing the purple trio on my eyes right now, and it's called Dream Glow. And I would say that the purple trio is actually my least favorite out of the bunch, surprisingly. It's still very pretty on the eyes, but it does come off a lot more plummy than it looks in the pan. I feel like this purple looks a lot more violet in the pan, but applied to the eyes, it definitely has a bit more of like a blackish base to it, which does make it really wearable, so I don't mind how the look turns out, but it just wasn't really what I expected. I really love the pink trio called Love Glow. I did an eye look with it the other day and it was so easy and came out so pretty. I want to describe the effect that Charlotte Tilbury eyeshadows give as kind of like a one and done eyeshadow, but in a palette form. It's kind of as if you're layering three or four different one and done eyeshadows to create just like a beautifully blown out dimensional look, and it's just so easy and effortless but really beautiful. Okay, next I definitely wanted to include some fashion favorites in this video. If you haven't seen it already, I did make a week in outfits that are Pinterest inspired, and I had such a fun time making that video and I really loved the outfits that I made in it. So I would say that those outfits are like favorites in themselves, but if we're being honest and I'm singling out like specific articles of clothing that I loved and wore a lot, I have to talk about my sweatshirts. This past month, I went through this whole ordeal of ordering so many different sizes and colors of the Aritzia Super Fleece sweatshirts and sweatpants. They have so many different fits and colors, and I'm the kind of person that just really needs to see all the options that are available so that I can really feel comfortable with my decision. But out of all the ones that I tried on and kept, this one is my favorite, and it's the oversized hooded sweatshirt in the shade Matte Pearl. I like the oversized sweatshirts in a size 1, and there's just something about the fit of this hoodie, especially in this color, that I feel like looks so good. I'm learning that my favorite cut for any kind of top is something that's a little bit boxier but not too oversized or long. So I love how these sweatshirts fit. I'm actually also wearing the crew neck super fleece in the color Modern Taupe. But out of everything, this is the one that I would recommend. I love the color of the matte pearl. It's kind of like a light neutral grayish beige color that's really classic and goes with everything. This color is great because it's not garment dyed like a lot of the Aritzia sweats. I've heard a lot of people have had issues with the garment dyed colors fading really quickly or getting stained, and the garment dyed ones actually aren't as soft and fluffy on the inside. So I do find that this hoodie is even just a little bit more warm and comfortable than the garment dyed ones that I have. And for my next fashion favorite, I don't have a particular item to share, but I've just been really loving cashmere sweaters a ton lately. I've gotten a couple of new ones and I'm on the hunt for the perfect collared cashmere sweater. And cashmere just really is such a superior fabric, I feel like. It's just so soft and lightweight and warm. I really hate wearing things that are super thick and bulky to keep me warm. I feel like it just weighs me down throughout the day and I feel really uncomfortable. And this leads me into my next favorite, because for a while I was so scared and didn't really know how I should take care of my more delicate cashmere and wool sweaters. But now I have a method down and it's so easy and I don't find it to be inconvenient at all. So the key product is this detergent, and this is by the brand Soak. But basically what this is a really nice gentle laundry detergent that you don't have to rinse out of your clothes. The more that you agitate and apply any friction to your more delicate wool and cashmere sweaters, the more likely that they're going to get damaged. So I love this detergent because when you're hand washing, you don't have to go through the second step of rinsing out the detergent. I also got this little plastic tub, which isn't essential to hand washing your clothes, but I feel like it really makes a difference for me. Previously, I would try hand washing my clothes in a bucket that was a lot more narrow than this, but because this is so wide, I feel like my sweaters have more room to breathe in it, if that makes sense. This tub is also really nice because it has some markings on the inside for measurements of water levels. So it's really easy to use. I just like stick it in my tub, fill it up with a gallon or two of water, depending on how many sweaters I'm washing. And then you just need to use a teaspoon of the detergent for every gallon. And then the final thing that's really annoying about washing sweaters and hand washing sweaters is having to air dry them. I bought a dehumidifier to help air dry my clothes a lot faster, and I've been really happy with it. Before, I would say that it took up to like 3 full days to completely air dry some of my sweaters. And with the dehumidifier, it's not instant, but I would say that my sweaters generally dry in about 24 hours. It's pretty energy efficient, so I don't feel bad running it for extended periods of time. And I've used it multiple times over the past month, and I feel like it really completes this system. It is something that's a little bit pricey for something that isn't really essential, but I've used it multiple times over the past month, and I feel like it just makes it so much easier and less of a headache for me to properly take care of my clothes. All right, next up I have one little productivity tool that I just wanted to mention. I've been using the app called Notion to just organize and document a bunch of random different things in my life. But recently I really started to use it to help organize the videos and things that I have planned for my YouTube channel. And what I love about Notion is that they have a bunch of different templates that you can use that I haven't really seen on any other kind of tool like this. And it just makes it feel really powerful and customizable, almost as if I'm like creating my own website for each little page. I have a little table that organizes all the upcoming videos that I wanna make and the date I wanna upload it, the day I might wanna film it. And then I can also click into each video itself and write a bunch of notes for it. So yeah, I've been really enjoying the tool. I think whether it's for personal or professional use, there are a bunch of different ways that you can use it, and I've found it really helpful so far. And then lastly, for my January favorites, I wanted to give a shout out to the drama that I'm currently watching. I started watching the Korean drama called True Beauty, and it's been really fun so far. I haven't really looked into the backstory or anything very much, but I think the drama was based on like a webcomic, and I used to love reading a bunch of shoujo manga, and I definitely get those kind of vibes from this drama. It's a romantic comedy, and of course the main characters' love stories are really fun and cute, but I think the other characters really make the drama come alive, and everyone is so quirky and funny, and there's just a lot of really fun, ridiculous moments that are just the right amount of ridiculous. If you've watched a lot of Korean dramas, you know that a lot of the family relationships can be kind of dramatic and unhealthy, but this is actually one of the few Korean dramas where I actually do enjoy watching the family dynamic. Let me know if you've been watching it, and if you haven't, I would definitely recommend if you're looking for a fun little rom-com to watch. And I think that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I know February is probably gonna be another super quick and fun month, and I'm looking forward to telling you what my favorites are for next month. Bye everyone, stay safe.